साई राम, मैं पंडित जी से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि वो अतिथि गणों के साथ आकर दीप प्रज्वलित करके आज की शाम का आगाज करें। भगवान श्री सत्य साईं बाबा एक अनोखा अद्भुत अवतार जिन्होंने इंसान को भगवान का दर्जा दिया। उन्होंने बताया कि वो तो भगवान है ही, हम सब भी भगवान हैं। आज यहाँ बैठे हुए लगभग 6000 लोग और दुनिया के कोने कोने में करोड़ों साईं भक्त जो इस प्रोग्राम को लाइव टेलीकास्ट द्वारा देख रहे हैं, उन सब में विराजे भगवान श्री सत्य साईं बाबा को मैं कोटे कोटे नमन करता हूँ। आप सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत और अभिनंदन करता हूँ। मैं पंडित जी से रिक्वेस्ट करता हूं, पंडित शिव कुमार शर्मा जी से, कि वो आकर आज के इस प्रोग्राम को की शुरुआत करें, दो शब्द आशीर्वचन के रूप में हमारे सामने कहें। पंडित शिव कुमार जी, पद्म विभूषण के अलावा उनका सबसे बड़ा तारुफ यह है कि वो भगवान श्री सत्य साईं बाबा के अनन्य भक्त हैं। मैं पंडित जी से रिक्वेस्ट करता हूं कि वो हमें आशीर्वचन दें।
ओम साई राम। सबसे पहले आप लोगों का स्वागत है कि आप आज यहां सब लोग आए हैं, और ये चंद एक बातें आपसे कहना चाहूंगा कि मैं यहां क्यों खड़ा हूं आज। थोड़ा सा आपको पीछे लेके जाऊंगा। 1969, उस समय मैंने स्वामी का नाम सुना और मैं उन लोगों में से था जिनको कहा जाता है स्केप्टिक्स हैं, विश्वास नहीं करने वाले लोग। और जब मैं उनसे मिला, मेरा यह सौभाग्य हुआ, तो एक मुलाकात में मुझे जो महसूस हुआ कि लव शब्द का अर्थ क्या है, प्यार क्या होता है, जो एक माँ भी किसी को प्यार उतना नहीं कर सकती उतना स्वामी प्यार करते हैं विदाउट एनी एक्सपेक्टेशंस। तो धीरे धीरे मैं उनको पहचानना शुरू किया। मैं एक म्यूजिशियन हूँ और मेरे प्रोफेशन की वजह से मैं दुनिया भर में घूमता रहा हूँ, और फिर एक ऐसा सिलसिला हुआ कि जहाँ भी मैं जाऊँ, स्कैंडिनेविया हो, रशिया हो, ग्रीस हो, यूके, अमेरिका, एनी पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, मुझे लोग मिल जाएं और वो लोग स्वामी से जुड़े हुए हैं। और आपको मैं ये बताना चाहूँ कि स्वामी अपनी शरीर रूप में जब यहाँ थे, मैं ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ कि अभी नहीं है, शरीर रूप में नहीं है, लेकिन अभी भी वो सुन रहे हैं, तो वो कहीं बाहर नहीं गए ईस्ट अफ्रीका के बगैर। और मैं इन लोगों को मिलूं तो वो उनके बारे में मुझे ऐसी ऐसी बातें बताएं कि वो कैसे उनसे जुड़ गए। तो ये स्वामी का सबसे बड़ा मिरेकल है। विदाउट एनी मीडिया, आज तो हमारे यहाँ मीडिया के मित्र बैठे हुए हैं, इतना कुछ ये प्रचार आज हो रहा है, उस जमाने में कोई मीडिया चैनल्स नहीं थे। एंड स्वामी वॉज लिविंग इन अ टाइनी विलेज इन आंध्र प्रदेश इन पुट्टपर्ती विच नोबडी न्यू, एंड ही नेवर केम ऑन द मीडिया, विच एवर मीडिया वॉज देयर, प्रिंट मीडिया और वॉट एवर। हाउ हिज मैसेज रीच्ड एवरीवेयर, दैट इज द बिगेस्ट मिरेकल ऑफ हिज लाइफ। एंड देन वॉट ही डिड साइलेंटली, ही डिडंट नीड एनी पब्लिसिटी टू डू दैट, एंड दैट इज वॉट वी हैव टू लर्न। हमको ये सीखना है कि बगैर किसी एक्सपेक्टेशन के, बगैर पब्लिसिटी के, हम सोसाइटी को क्या दे सकते हैं। स्वामी ने जो हॉस्पिटल बनाए, दुनिया में मिसाल है कि हॉस्पिटल में कैश काउंटर नहीं है, ऐसा हॉस्पिटल आपने कहीं देखा है, सुना है? हमारे भारत में जब भारत आज़ाद हुआ तो कुछ चीज़ों की ज़रूरत थी। सबसे पहली थी एजुकेशन। एजुकेशन को स्वामी बोलते थे एडुकेयर, एजुकेशन विद केयर विद लव, वो उन्होंने निःशुल्क सब लोगों को दी। उसके अलावा ड्रिंकिंग वाटर, ये कुछ बातें आपको सब दिखाई जाएंगी, अभी मैं थोड़ा थोड़ा आपको सिर्फ जिक्र कर रहा हूँ जो मैंने नज़दीक से देखा। और एक बात, एज ए म्यूजिशियन, हम लोग म्यूज़िक को जनरली स्पीकिंग वी थिंक इट्स एन एंटरटेनमेंट, बट इन इंडिया इन आवर एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशन ऑफ दिस कंट्री, म्यूज़िक एंड स्पिरिचुअलिटी, संगीत और आध्यात्म एक ही सिक्के के दो पहलू हैं। और इसी वजह से स्वामी ने अपना मैसेज संकीर्तन, भजन, उसके ज़रिए पहुंचाया। और मैंने ऐसे भजन सिर्फ पुट्टपर्ती में सुने, जो अभी आप सुन रहे थे शुरू में, कि जिसमें हर मज़हब का जिक्र होता है, वो सब एक हैं। तो आज जो प्रोग्राम हम पेश करने जा रहे हैं, उस कड़ी में एक मैसेज है कि हमारे बड़े देश के बड़े बड़े कलाकार आपके सामने आएंगे और वो आपको भजन सुनाएंगे। अभी मैं कुछ देर पहले मीडिया से बात कर रहा था तो उन्होंने मुझे पूछा कि मुंबई इज़ द फाइनेंशियल कैपिटल ऑफ इंडिया, और आज बड़े बड़े लोग यहाँ पर आ रहे हैं, बैंकर्स आएंगे, कौन कौन लोग आएंगे, उनसे आपको क्या अपेक्षा है? तो मैं उनसे यही कह रहा था कि उनसे ये अपेक्षा है कि ये जो सेवा है, नीडी पीपल, व्हाट दे रिक्वायर, एजुकेशन, फूड, हेल्थ, उसमें जो सत्य सेवा, ये सत्य साई हमारा जो संस्था जो काम कर रही है, उसमें जो भी आप मदद कर सकते हैं, ये आपका मैं दायित्व तो समझता हूँ। अगर आप करेंगे तो इतने लोगों तक वो मैसेज पहुँचेगा और उनको लाभ होगा। बाकी मैं ज़्यादा समय नहीं लूँगा, आपको एवीज दिखाए जाएंगे। और एक बात सिर्फ लास्ट में कहना चाह रहा हूँ कि शरीर रूप में स्वामी हमारे साथ नहीं है, लेकिन फिर वही मेरे साथ हो रहा है। मैं दुनिया भर में घूमता हूँ और आज भी वो अपना काम किए चले जा रहे हैं, केवल हिंदुस्तान में नहीं, पूरी दुनिया में। और ये वो शख्स बोल रहा है जो 1969 में ही वॉज ए स्केप्टिक, ही डिडंट बिलीव इन दिस। आई एम एक्सपीरियंसिंग इट टुडे दैट स्वामी हैज लेफ्ट हिज बॉडी बट हिज मिशन इज ऑन, दैट वर्क इज ऑन एंड इट्स वाइडली स्प्रेडिंग ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। और आपसे यही मेरी प्रार्थना है कि आप इसमें कुछ योगदान करिए और जिसमें पूरी दुनिया का भला हो। धन्यवाद।
मैं रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा हमारे राजाध्यक्ष श्री रमेश सावंत जी से कि वो आकर पंडित शिव जी का अभिनंदन करेंगे। श्री रमेश सावंत जी। मैं आमंत्रित करता हूं हमारे श्री सत्य साई सेवा संगठन के ऑल इंडिया वाइस प्रेसिडेंट श्री निमिष पंड्या जी, जो श्री सत्य साई ट्रस्ट महाराष्ट्र के ट्रस्टी भी हैं, जो आज मेरे साथ सह संचालक हैं इस प्रोग्राम के। मैं उनको निमंत्रित करता हूं कि वो स्टेज पर आएं। श्री निमिष पंड्या जी।
Om Shri Sai Ram. Offering my most humble salutations at the divine lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan Shri Satya Sai Baba, on behalf of all present here today, I invoke his blessings that he may grant bliss, happiness and absolute peace to every mankind, every part of the world, the entire cosmos. Today's function specially so, as Shri Indralal Shah mentioned to me, that this is a function for the world to know that Swami is with us in this auditorium right now, watching and guiding us on this feature. A program to offer tribute to our Divine Master, who is omnipresent, omniscient and omnipotent. The power that guides entire mankind, the power that guides the entire cosmos. He descended on earth so that mankind can understand that he is not an ordinary being, that he also is equally divine as the master himself. He knew very well that in the age that we live today, entire problem of mankind emotes from only one factor, and that is lack of unconditional love that every human being deserves on the face of this earth. And that's exactly what man doesn't do. And it's for this purpose that Bhagwan descended on earth, to teach all of us to grant unconditional love to every human being. And therefore he said his very famous quotation, love all and serve all. He knew that he resides in the heart of every human being. For the first time in the history of mankind, if anybody could give the address of the divine, it was Bhagwan Shri Sat Sai Baba, who then said that if I ever reside anywhere on the cosmos, it is in the heart of every human being. And therefore he gave the next beautiful quotation. He says, help ever and hurt never, because he is in every being. To such a master, we gather here today to offer our most humble salutations. Bhagwan was known. He knew how to treat and convert, and how to treat and ensure that there is transformation in every individual human being. He said that if there is righteousness in the heart, then there is beauty in character. If there is beauty in character, then there is harmony in the home. If there is harmony in the home, then alone there will be order in the nation. And then alone there will be peace in the world. This sequence, brothers and sisters, is the classic strategy of Bhagwan Shri Sat Sai Baba to bring and grant peace to entire mankind. And this cannot be breached by anyone. We have to first transform ourselves, as he said, by righteousness, by enlightening our beautiful character. And then the home. Today's bane is people ignore the home and go outside to help. But Bhagwan was never happy with this. Bhagwan insisted that ensure that your home is a happy home, and then alone step in the world, then a bold step in nation, and then try to go and peace the world. Brothers and sisters, it's indeed a very great occasion here today to be present amidst all of you beautiful devotees here gathered to offer tribute to our Divine Master. And I'm sure he is there raising both his hands and blessing each one of us sitting here in this auditorium. Children were very, very dear to our beloved Master. In fact, the very first thing he did was to teach bhajans. And bhajans with Bal Vikas children is an amazing institution that Bhagwan started. Bhagwan said, teach children bhajans and see how they transform. And that's what has been happening for the last more than 4 decades in the Sri Sathya Sai Bal Vikas program. In Maharashtra, we had recently a bhajan mahotsavam, and all the children participated. And brothers and sisters, what you see today on the stage, young beautiful faces who are the winners of the Maharashtra bhajan competition. Each one a superstar, each one an embodiment of the divine, and each one where Swami resides in the heart and reflects through their eyes and through their voice. Without taking too much time, brothers and sisters, I am now going to be presenting to you the Sri Sathya Sai Bal Vikas children who will be singing before you. The top 4 winners will be presenting beautiful bhajans. Let's sit back, close our eyes, and see the divine presence of Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba through the beautiful Bal Vikas children. Jai Sai Ram.
पशुपति तनया बाल गजानन तुम ओम दिमिका दिमिका दीम दिमिका दिमिका दीम आचे
Oh.
ज्योति जलाओ, ज्योति जलाओ, अखंड ज्योति जलाओ, ज्योति जलाओ, साई मन मंदिर में, साई मन मंदिर में, अखंड ज्योति जलाओ। Oh,
I think you need to really pepper yourself and give a real big applause to the children. Sri Satya Sai Bal Vikas all over the world. More than 2 million children in more than 135 countries. More than a few lakh Bal Vikas gurus. And more than a few thousands centers all over the world. And you know what's the speciality of this? Not a single guru is a professionally trained guru. Because Bhagwan said, in due tribute to womanhood, he said, every woman, every mother is a Bal Vikas guru, every home is a Bal Vikas class, and every child is a Bal Vikas child, is what Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba mentioned. It was his dream that every home should become a Bal Vikas home. Every mother should become a child. More than four decades, brothers and sisters, lakhs and lakhs of children have passed through the Bal Vikas movement with the divine blessings of the Master himself. Many of them have attained great status in life. And today, we have amongst us one such personality. Born to very devout parents, mother and father, both devotees of Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Married into a very illustrious family, with the world respects. But beyond both these facts, a persona, which through the 9 years of the Bal Vikas movement has established herself the strongest character that Bhagwan would have wished. We remember her as a young girl who participated in a drama before Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba called the Akhand Bharat, who participated in a mega event called the Cosmos, which we did in the stadium in Prashanthi Nilayam. A young girl that attracted everybody's attention. But many knew that as she grows up, she'll follow the path of excellence, became the Miss Universe, Miss World, the most beautiful woman on the face of this earth. But that's not enough. She became an actor par excellence. But that's not enough. At heart, she remained a very simple, humble human being, always grounded on the roots of human values. And brothers and sisters, we have with us today Srimati Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, whom we all know as Aishwarya, the young Bal Vikas student of Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba, and we're indeed grateful for Aishwarya to have consented to our invitation to be present here today. It means a lot to the Bal Vikas movement that you're here today. Children all over the world would be excited, children all over the world would be energized that if you can do what Bhagwan taught you to do, everybody can do what you can do. Jai Sai Ram. I invite Aishwarya Bachchan to be on the stage and grant the certificates to the Bal Vikas children who have passed out from this beautiful bhajan movement. Please welcome Aishwarya Rai Bachchan. At the outset, before she grants the certificates to the children, I'd request Srimati Kamala Pandya, the All India Deputy Bal Vikas Coordinator of India, to felicitate Srimati Aishwarya Rai. She will be accompanied by Mrs. Midula Saxena and Srimati Neela Bhatia. We have the first award winner, Avantika Ashok from Mumbai, coming forward, followed by Anushka Hubli from Thane, followed by Shweta Sandeep Pawar from Dhule. These are between the age group of 6 and 8, which we often call the group one. The next group is 8 to 10 years, Master Sarvesh Ingle from Amravati, Satish Hebar from Thane, Krishna Chakrapani from Mumbai, Saishwari Anand from Navi Mumbai. The group 10 to 12 years, Suyash Topale from Pune, Vibhuti Kalyanpur from Mumbai, Mayuresh Vankhade from Amravati, Sarthak Bhatt, this is the group 12 to 14 years. We have Sarthak R. Bhatt, Nashik, Sai Krishna Warrior from Thane, and Purna Chauhan from Mumbai. Please give them a big hand, ladies and sisters. After the felicitation, I would sincerely request Srimati Aishwarya Rai Bachchan to say a few words of encouragement to the Bal Vikas children of the world, of her experience as a Bal Vikas student.
Sai Ram.
Sai Ram.
Good evening, Namaskar. Pranam to the lotus feet of Baba. And I must confess, this is just such a humbling and emotional experience for me today. There are so many things that I'm feeling right now that I'm not sure I'm going to be much of an orator, but I still would love to share try and put to words all that I'm feeling, all that I've experienced. I consider myself truly blessed to be the daughter of my parents, to begin with. They're the reason I have been introduced and blessed to have experienced the divine love and blessings, and as Nimish Uncle rightly put it, the unconditional love of Baba. And having had the opportunity to actually have been a Bal Vikas student, there's so much gratitude I feel at this moment. listening to you, Nimishankar, Kamala Aunty, all my gurus, all my fellow students, all you Balvika students, I know exactly what you all are feeling right now. I know exactly what you all have experienced about the competition. I had the wonderful opportunity of participating so many times, had the opportunity to place a couple of times, and had the grace and blessings to have actually sung bhajans as well in front of Baba at Dharmakshetra at Puttaparthi. I just met Deepak uncle, Mr. Deepak Majumdar, and just yesterday I was recounting with Nimish uncle and Kamala aunty how we had the opportunity to perform the cosmos dance in Puttaparthi. I know what we all can probably, when we put it down to words, can only say this is an experience. It's a faith, it's an experience. It cannot be defined, it does not need to be defined. And that's what we all very strongly feel, and probably that's why we do not feel the need to explain or over-explain what this experience is all about. But I definitely would like to share and express that so early in life I had the opportunity to experience such wonderful guidance. I had the opportunity to discover not just the word Nishkam Karma, but actually know what that feels like. And that is what we got to experience, Balvika students would know, with our gurus. When we were introduced to life for what it is, we were guided, I won't use the word taught, we were guided and shown what and how you can experience selfless love, what the meaning of service to mankind is, service to God really is, what the pillars of Satya, Dharma, Shanti, Prema feels like, what when we say, and we all do on in life, on platforms, whenever we have the opportunity, we'll say all religions are one, all faiths lead to one. But we actually got to experience that. We actually got to actually feel that energy, feel that spirit. When simple little experiences, like there were times, Balvika's classes were on Sunday mornings. I don't know if that still is the case, but Sunday mornings. And you're a regular kid, you know, television was big, it was just beginning to boom. And there would be all those interesting serials and cartoons at the same time that you find your peer group really enjoyed indulging in. That's fine. Today, guess what? I'm part of entertainment, I'm part of showbiz. But at the time and at that age, to have had the inner calm to actually feel you're making the choice to go to Balvika's class as opposed to watching cartoons and enjoying being there. I could see that joy right now in all the children when you're singing bhajans continuously, to actually feel that joy and that energy, to have that kind of focus and attention span. It's an age when you can get so easily distracted, but that inner calm, you don't realize you're beginning to experience and find that. And so much later today in life, with the whirlwind experiences of all that life throws your way, you will realize how precious that guidance has been in all your experiences ahead on in the journey of life. I definitely have felt that, and I have always attributed that. When, you know, in interviews, people will ask, how do you face praise or how do you face criticism? And I would always say it's a very, it's a middle path feeling. It's a middle path approach, because that's the simplest way I could put it in words. And people would attribute to, is this the Buddhist approach? And is it? And I'm like, honestly, in my head, I'm thinking, I can't define it. In an interview, it might feel cool to say, yeah. But very honestly, it is that what you discovered and what one got to realize through these early formative years. Our parents, Nimishankal, I completely know what you say when you say our parents are our guiding force, and every home is, can be, should be, will be a Bal Vikas institution. But also, we get to enjoy that experience also with the guidance of this, call it a movement, call it, but I'll just call it an experience. Panditji put it beautifully when you, and I know why you shared that, when you said ki sabse pehle jab aapko is, aapko Baba se introduce kiya gaya, ya the thought or the concept or the idea of it, you were one of the skeptics. I know why you've actually shared that, because there are many. And to all of them, I'd just like to share that it's fine if that is your faith and that's your belief, it's perfectly okay. Choose to walk away or choose to experience what we all experience here. It's a matter of your choice. But I don't think that's an opportunity for actually wearing veils of judgment. It's good values, it's goodness, and goodness cannot be judged. It's nishkam karma, it's unconditional love, there is free service to your fellow people, there's education, there's medical services, there's, I remember we were made to because we chant 108 times or 21 times Om Sai Ram. There was a time during Jap that we were just told, we bring a bag full of rice from home and we all just jap, and whatever comes in your fingers, 3 grains or a fistful, you just keep putting that. And at the end of it, everybody's portions were put together and cooked in one huge top. And we all were taken to a village where we hand-served people that food that was cooked. It's a very simple action, but so many values were taught by that one experience. You realize the value of it with time. You realize the value of it the more we live in society and the more you get to see how much we as people choose in such a frivolous way to create divides and how irrelevant that all is. I have had the good fortune through my vocation, jab Panditji ne kaha ki kala ya sangeet and spirituality ek hi coin ke do pehlu hai. Every professional, every kalakar will completely agree with that. But also we have had the blessing to have the opportunity to be standing here on a public platform, to be given this, the opportunity and the opportunity to share our experiences, our viewpoint to a blessed receptive audience. It's a huge blessing. And I have always maintained that the more such opportunity I have got with God's blessings, it is only to continue sharing the values, the guidance, the goodness that was taught to us or inculcated so early in life, and to be able to share that through different acts of reproducing and recreating that very guidance. And that is what I consider the biggest blessing I have had by getting the opportunity to be on a public platform. And I hope to be a good student. I hope to be and to be able to recreate the values that have been taught and inculcated. And I mean, I can go on and on. I know you're like clapping and saying, come on, next person's turn. But Nimish uncle, I can go on and on. I'd just like to share one more incident. When I was talking about an experience, since you recounted or you helped me recollect one of the performances on stage. And I was telling Panditji, I said, you won't know, but as one of these students, I have witnessed you performing with all the great masters of music. And it was such a blessing even then to be able to understand and appreciate this, the art, our culture, our values. And I think that's also because of guidance. We don't realize, but we actually retain and hold on and recognize so much, educate ourselves so much through all these experiences. You all are very fortunate to be introduced to music like this, to be introduced to bhajan singing like this. It's all a discipline. And so in one of those plays, one of my early opportunities to act, and I didn't know I'd be an actor eventually, I barely had one line in the play. And this performance was in Dharmakshetra in front of Baba, which was a big deal. Everybody was very excited that we had had that blessing and that opportunity. And because the show was getting probably very long, or Baba just said, this is it. Two different messages came backstage. That play was cancelled and I was going to come at the end of that play. Oh, and everybody was crying and breaking down. And I didn't know whether I was supposed to cry or not, because I didn't know what I was feeling. But my teammates were all really upset for different reasons, because they were people of different age groups who recognized that opportunity differently. For some, it was the opportunity to perform in front of Baba, I'm sure most of the team. For some, it was just to act. Some were all dressed up and ready, depending on our different age groups. And I was also then beginning to feel shattered and very let down, and not knowing how could Baba do this? How could we all be denied this experience? Not knowing that we were going to have the opportunity in Puttaparthi ahead. And also, I got fortunate and was given the opportunity then. I was picked amongst the students to go and garland Baba. So I go on stage thinking, how could you do this? I had that expression, and I remember saying, you cancelled our play, when I went to garland him, not knowing again what that could mean. That moment would mean so much more for anybody sitting out there, but I was feeling so bad for the entire team. And the closer I came to Baba, and he just said, oh ho ho Kanna, I know what you're saying, Panditji. That love, that unconditional love, that mamta. And I broke down. And ever since, whenever I had the opportunity to garland him, with which some blessing I got so many times, I would always be brought to tears. No one asked, no one told, no one said that's the response to be given. It's just the experience of immense love that would evoke that response. And I'm blessed to have had that experience, and I thank you all immensely for it. Thank you.
May I now have the opportunity, in the presence of Srimati Bachchan and Pandit Shiv Kumar Sharma, to invite the artists of today evening's program. I first invite on stage Sri Anoop Jalota, Sri Pankaj Udhas, Srimati Kavita Krishnamurti, Srimati Padmaja Joglekar, Srimati Richa Sharma, Sri Gaurav Chopra, Sri Keshav Prasad, Sri Sumit Tapu, and Sri Bhavdeep Jaipurwale.
Sir, pratham hum bulate hain bhajan samrat Sri Anoop Jalota ji ko. हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से श्री मुकेश पटेल. अनूप जी आगे आए आप प्लीज. अनूप जलोटा जी आइए. सर्वप्रथम सम्मानित करते हैं हम श्री अनूप जलोटा जी को, भजन सम्राट श्री अनूप जलोटा जी को.
हो गया.
उसके पश्चात पद्मश्री पंकज उदास जी.
पंकज उदास.
उसके बाद पद्मश्री श्रीमती कविता कृष्णमूर्ति, श्रीमती रश्मि सावंत, उनका अभिनंदन करेंगे. इसके बाद पद्मश्री श्रीमती पद्मजा जोगलेकर, श्रीमती हंसा भरवानी, उनका अभिनंदन करेंगी साथ में पंडित जी के और ऐश्वर्य जी के. इसके बाद मिस ऋचा शर्मा, उनका अभिनंदन करेंगी श्रीमती पद्मा दिवाकर. श्री गौरव चोपड़ा, इनका फेलिसिटेशन करेंगे श्री विजय भास्कर. श्री विजय भास्कर एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर रिजर्व बैंक. उसके बाद श्री केशव प्रसाद, जिनका फेलिसिटेशन हमारी ओर से करेंगे श्री कामदार जी. श्री भवदीप जयपुर वाले, जिनका फेलिसिटेशन करेंगे हमारी ओर से श्री शिवाजी राव जाधव जी. श्री सुमित टप्पू जी, जिनका फेलिसिटेशन करेंगे श्री मेहुल परब. कनौडिया जी, आप स्वागत करें श्री पंकज उदास जी का. हम अपने आदरणीय गेस्ट सारे आर्टिस्ट को रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे कि वो अपना अपना स्थान ग्रहण करें। हम श्री आदित्य पुरी जी को इनवाइट करते हैं कि वो ऊपर आए, उनका सत्कार होगा। आदित्य पुरी जी HDFC बैंक के CEO और मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर हैं। हमारी ओर से श्री समीर भाटिया, सत्साई बुक्स एंड पब्लिकेशंस ट्रस्ट के ट्रस्टी, उनका अभिनंदन करेंगे। आदित्य पुरी जी दो शब्द कहेंगे हम लोगों से।
साई राम, we all gathered here today to pay homage to a great soul who imbibed and taught us all the values of selfless love, service, devotion and humility. When I first visited Puttupati, I was absolutely amazed and overwhelmed. People from all walks of life, from all over the world, living in the ashram in an atmosphere of selfless love, devotion, service and the utmost humility. It left a lasting impression in my mind. I also at that point of time visited the medical institutions, I visited the schools, I visited the outreach programs, and I could carry on and on. But what I was left amazed was, how could one man do so much for the benefit of mankind? I visited Puttupati again for a second time at the request of Mr. Vijay Bhaskar, and I interacted with the students at Satya Sai University. The recurring theme that came through in their questions was, how are we going to cope with the world, given all that was, they wanted to say, evil with the world and what we learn here. I told them it was a trifle unfair to paint the whole world with the same brush. I assure you the majority of the population does believe in the same values as you, and going forward all of you imbibing these values will make the world a better place to live in. I wish you all the best. I've taken enough of your time. Sai Ram.
उमेश, इसके बाद फर्स्ट ऑडियो विजुअल प्रेजेंट करें।
द डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन सर्विस एनीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड एंड एज इंस्पायर्ड बाय भगवान इन द सत्य साई सेवा ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज वेरी यूनिक। इन द सत्य साई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन भगवान टॉट अस टू सर्व एंड ऑफर इट टू द डिवाइन इमीडिएटली। The world may recognize service and encourage and acknowledge the people who serve, but here every act of service is dedicated to the divine lotus feet, and nobody claims any doership, because Bhagwan taught us that the only hurdle between man and God is a sense of doership which we develop. And once you sacrifice a sense of doership, that is the end, and the deep emergence of divine lotus feet is a must. Ladies and gentlemen, let's begin today evening's program with the great artists offering themselves. May I tell you one thing? Each and every artist sitting on the stage today is stalwart in his own right or her own right, but is absolutely devoted, and his presence here is only because of their love for Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba.
Wo yaaron ki mehfil, wo muskurate hue pal, दिल से जुड़ा हुआ है अपना बीता हुआ कल। कभी जिंदगी गुजरती थी मौज और मस्ती में, आज वक्त गुजरता है साईं चरणन में। भगवान बाबा का दिया हुआ सबसे पहला भजन आपके सामने प्रस्तुत है, मानस भजरे गुरु चरणम।
भजने गुरु चरणों दुस्तर भव सागर करूं। चरणम दुस्तर भव सागर
Oh, no. चरणम दुस्तर भव सागर तरणम।
दुनिया में शायद ऐसा कोई दूसरा मुकाम नहीं होगा जहां संगीत की दुनिया के इतने बड़े बड़े कलाकार एक साथ भगवान को श्रद्धांजलि देने के लिए मौजूद हैं। एक बार तालियों से बहुत बहुत स्वागत करें। अब हम सुनेंगे भजन सम्राट अनूप जलोटा जी को। लगन लगाओ साईं से तो पलकों और आंखों की तरह, लगन लगाओ साईं से तो पलकों और आंखों की तरह, अगर आंखों में कुछ चला जाए तो पलकें तड़प उठती हैं, और अगर पलकें कुछ देर न झपकें तो आंखें रो उठती हैं। ऐसी लागी लगन मीरा हो गई मगन।
सारे गा पा धा पा मा धा पा पा धा पा गरे गा धा पा गरे रे मा पा धा पा गरे नी धा रे पानी रे मा धा मा रे नी धा मा धा नी रे नी धा रे सा है आंख वो है आंख वो जो शाम का दर्शन किया करे है शीश जो प्रभु चरण में वंदन किया करे बेकार वो मुख है बेकार वो मुख है जो रहे व्यर्थ बातों में बेकार वो मुख है जो रहे व्यर्थ बातों में मुख वो है जो हरि नाम का सुमिरन किया करे हीरे मोती से नहीं शोभा है हाथ की है हाथ जो भगवान का पूजन किया करे मर कर भी अमर नाम है उस जीव का जग में प्रभु प्रेम में बलिदान जो जीवन किया करे ऐसी लागी लगन ये जो लंबी सांस है इसका राज मैंने आज तक किसी को नहीं बताया, लेकिन आज मैं बताना चाहता हूं। ये लंबी सांस का राज है बाबा रामदेव के प्राणायाम। एक आदमी बाबा रामदेव के प्राणायाम किया करता था, बड़ी अच्छी उसकी सेहत हो गई। 105 साल में उसकी मृत्यु हुई। ऊपर पहुंचा
तो स्वर्ग के दरवाजे पर एक बड़ी खूबसूरत अप्सरा ने उसको एक ड्रिंक देके उसका स्वागत किया, वेलकम टू स्वर्ग। मजा आ गया उसे कि क्या स्वागत हुआ। और आगे गया तो एक और अप्सरा आई, उसने आके एक गुलाब के फूलों की माला उसके गले में डाली, वेलकम टू स्वर्ग। उसकी तबीयत खुश हो गई, वाह क्या स्वागत हुआ। और आगे गया, एक और अप्सरा आई, उसने आके एक आइटम डांस करके दिखाया, वेलकम टू स्वर्ग। उसकी तबीयत खुश हो गई। मन ही मन सोचने लगा कि ये बाबा रामदेव के चक्कर में मैं लेट हो गया आने में। आप लोग प्राणायाम कर रहे हैं तो यह नुकसान हो सकता है।
ऐसी लागी लगन, ऐसी लागी लगन, लागी लागी रे लगन, लागी लागी रे लगन, ऐसी लागी लगन, मीरा हो गई मगन।
ये तो भजन हम लोग मिलके गा सकते हैं। एक लाइन में गाता हूं उसे, आप दोहराएं, तैयार हो जाएं।
ऐसी लागी लगन, मीरा हो गई मगन, ऐसी
बहुत अच्छा गाते हैं आप लोग, एक बार और।
ऐसी लागी लगन, मीरा हो गई मगन, वो तो गली 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 हरि गुण गाने लगी। ऐसी लागी लगन, मीरा हो गई मगन, वो तो गली गली हरि गुण गाने लगी। महलों में पली बन के जोगन चली, महलों में पली बन के जोगन चली, मीरा रानी दीवानी कहने लगी। ऐसी लागी लगन, मीरा हो गई मगन, वो तो गली 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 हरि गुण गाने लगी। ऐसी लागी लगन,
बहुत सुंदर पंक्तियां हैं, ध्यान दीजिएगा।
कोई रोके नहीं, कोई टोके नहीं, मीरा गोविंद गोपाल गाने लगी। कोई रोके, नहीं कोई टोके नहीं, मीरा गोविंद गोपाल गाने लगी। बैठी संतों के संग, रंगी मोहन के रंग, मीरा प्रेमी प्रीतम को मनाने लगी। वो तो गली गली हरि गुण गाने लगी। ऐसी लागी लगन, मीरा हो गई मगन, वो तो गली 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 हरि गुण गाने लगी। महलों में पली बन के जोगन चली, मीरा रानी दीवानी कहने लगी। ऐसी लगी लगन, विष दिया मानो अमृत पिया, मीरा सागर में सरिता समाने लगी। राणा ने विष दिया मानो अमृत पिया, सानी धानी धाबा 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 गरेगा सरे नि सा धनी बदनी।
विष दिया मानो अमृत पिया, मीरा सागर में सरिता समाने लगी, दुख लाखों सहे मुख से गोविंद कहे, मीरा गोविंद गोपाल गाने लगी, वो तो गली गली हरी गुण गाने लगी, ऐसी लागी लगन मीरा हो गई मगन, वो तो गली गली हरी गुण गाने लगी, मैं डूबी पली बन के जोगन चली, मीरा रानी दीवानी कहने लगी, ऐसी लागी लगन मीरा हो गई मगन, ऐसी लागी लगन मीरा हो गई मगन, ऐसी लागी लगन मीरा हो गई मगन।
अनूप जी भगवान के बहुत बड़े भक्त हैं, लेकिन यहाँ बहुत से लोगों को शायद ये नहीं मालूम होगा कि वो लक्ष्मी जी के भी भक्त हैं और उनका लक्ष्मी जी के साथ साक्षात्कार भी हुआ है। मैं चाहूँगा कि अनूप जी हम सबको उसके बारे में बताएं।
रंगे हमारे सांझ सवेरे हैं बाबा, हम तो तेरे हैं, जैसे भी हैं अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे हैं, जैसे भी हैं अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे हैं, तेरे रंग में रंगे हमारे सांझ सवेरे हैं बाबा, हम तो तेरे हैं, जैसे भी हैं अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे। कहते हैं शिरडी वाले लोग, तेरे बारे में कहते हैं शिरडी वाले लोग, तूने जिसको छुआ न आया उसको कोई रोग, तूने ही हर दिन दुखी के दुर्दिन फेरे हैं बाबा, हम तो तेरे हैं, जैसे भी हैं अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे हैं।
हजारों आते तेरे द्वार, दूर दूर से लोग हजारों आते तेरे द्वार, जो भी तेरे द्वार आया पाया उसने प्यार, तेरा दर वो जहां से कोसों दूर अंधेरे हैं, बाबा हम तो तेरे हैं, जैसे भी हैं अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे हैं। जहां जहां पूजा हो तेरी वहां न दुख का काम, जहां जहां पूजा हो तेरी वहां न दुख का काम, कोई करे सलाम तुझे तो कोई करे प्रणाम, कोई करे सलाम तुझे तो कोई करे प्रणाम, उनको हर पल सुख जो तेरी माला फेरे हैं, बाबा हम तो तेरे हैं, जैसे भी हैं अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे हैं, तेरे रंग में रंग हमारे सांझ सवेरे हैं, बाबा हम तो तेरे हैं, ओ बाबा साईं बाबा, ओ बाबा वो साईं बाबा, ओ बाबा वो बाबा, जैसे भी है अब हे साईं हम तो तेरे हैं, हम तो तेरे हैं, हम तो तेरे।
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया अनूप जी। जैसे भाई अनूप बता रहे थे, श्री अनूप सक्सेना इज द डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द सिटी ऑफ मुंबई, लुकिंग आफ्टर ऑल द मैसेज इन मिशन ऑफ भगवान इन मुंबई। वो अभी आपसे जिक्र कर रहे थे कि शायद जिंदगी में पहली बार ऐसा हुआ होगा कि इतनी बड़ी शख्सियत संगीत के जगत की एक साथ मिलकर भगवान के चरणों में अपनी साधना अर्पण करते हैं। मगर सिर्फ ये संगीत के जगत के लोगों की बात नहीं है, हमारे बीच आज ऐसी ऐसी हस्तियाँ बैठी हैं जिनका जिक्र करना बहुत आवश्यक है, और ख़ास करके मैं जिक्र करूंगा श्री गोपीनाथ मुंडे जी और श्री अशोक चव्हाण जी, जो आज हमारे साथ हमारे हैं। ये दोनों शख्सियत की एक बहुत खूबसूरत कहानी मुझे बाबा के समक्ष की याद आती है। बाबा पिछली बार जब बम्बई आए थे तो अशोक जी चीफ मिनिस्टर थे और गोपीनाथ जी ऑपोजिशन के लीडर, और दोनों भगवान के सत्यदीप में आमने सामने खड़े थे और बैठे थे और भगवान का इंतज़ार कर रहे थे। पहले अशोक जी खड़े होकर भगवान के चरणों में कुछ अर्पण किया, उन्होंने कुछ शब्द अर्पण किए, और फिर गोपीनाथ जी की बारी आई। तब गोपीनाथ जी ने एक बहुत खूबसूरत बात बताई थी कि बाहर के जगत में हम भले ऑपोजिशन पार्टी हो, भगवान के चरणों में ऑल ऑपोजिशन मर्ज टुगेदर एज वन डिवाइन सिंह। और ये वाक्य मुझे बहुत ही अच्छी तरीके से याद है, और जिसका जिक्र मुझे आज दोनों शख्सियतें बैठी हैं और सर, वी वेलकम यू टुडे इन टुडेज इवनिंग प्रोग्राम. श्री अशोक चव्हाण, मिसेज चव्हाण, गोपीनाथ मुंडे जी, आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है. और उनके साथ में हमारे बहुत ही एक अच्छे मोघे साहब बैठे हैं. आप लोगों को पता नहीं, मोघे जी इज़ अ वेरी सीनियर मिनिस्टर इन द कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट. बट मोघे जी, टू हिज क्रेडिट गोज दैट ही इज ऑल्सो सर्व्ड एज अ सेवादल वॉलंटियर ऑफ भगवान श्री सत्य साई बाबा फॉर मेनी मेनी ईयर्स, एंड आई थिंक दैट ह्यूमिलिटी गोज टू हिम. श्री मुंगन तिवार, हु इज द अदर गेस्ट, एंड वी हैव विजय पाटिल सिटिंग देयर वेरी क्वाइटली. He was the illustrious son of Shri D.Y. Patil, the governor of Haryana, who's sitting there very nicely. Welcome, Vijay Patil. Welcome to you. And we have the immense privilege of having all our members of the Shri Satya Sai Central Trust, and foremost amongst them, Shri K. Chakravarti, who has been looking after Swami for so many years. Esteemed Mr. Chakravarti with us. Welcome, sir. Wish you. Shri Naganand and Mrs. Naganand being there with us, who looks after all the legal issues of the Central Trust, a member of the Central Trust. And most uniquely, brothers and sisters, we have with us today Bhagwan's nephew and the member of the Central Trust, Shri Ratnakar and Mrs. Ratnakar, with us today, present here with all of us in this day. We're indeed very grateful to all of you for being with us. But more than anything else, it gives us great pleasure today for having with us the Doyen, the Bhishma Pitama of the Satya Sai Seva Organization of the world. What Krishna and Arjuna meant in the Mahabharata, what Arjuna was to Krishna, I always used to wonder if there is a parallel in modern times. And there is, brothers and sisters, the parallel to Arjuna and Krishna. If Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba was the Krishna of modern age, then there was one Arjuna with him, and that was the great Doyen, Bhishma Pitama, whom we call Shri Indulal Shah.
ఇట్టి పునాదులకు ఇట్టి ధర్మక్షేత్ర నిర్మాణములకును ఇందులాల్ షా అనేది మూల కారణము.
ఇందులాల్ షా ఈజ్ మెయిన్లీ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ లేయింగ్ ద ఫౌండేషన్ ఫర్ ద ధర్మక్షేత్ర.
భగవత్ కార్యాల లోపల, భగవత్ కర్మల లోపల ప్రవేశించినటువంటి వ్యక్తులు కొన్ని కష్టములకు తట్టుకొని నెట్టుకొని రావాలి.
Those who are involved in these divine tasks and assignments must be prepared to face these problems.
ఇట్టు సాధించుకుంటూ వచ్చినటువంటి వాడు ఇందులాష.
ఇందులాష హస్ అచీవ్డ్ అకంప్లిష్డ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వే.
ముఖ్యంగా స్వామి యొక్క చింత చేతనే భవిష్యత్తు ఏ విధంగా చేయాలి, ఎట్లా నిర్మించాలి అనేటువంటి దీంతో నిరంతరం రాత్రి పగలు అనాహారాలు మానేరు.
హిస్ కాన్స్టెంట్ వరీ అండ్ యాంగ్జైటీ ఇస్ దిస్ ద ఫ్యూచర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆర్గనైజేషన్ వాట్ ఈస్ టు బి డన్. హి హస్ సాక్రిఫైస్డ్ హిస్
ఫ్రీడమ్. ప్రపంచం అంతా సంచరించి అనేక ప్రజలకు సాయతత్వాన్ని చక్కగా ప్రబోధిస్తూ వచ్చాడు.
హి వెంట్ రౌండ్ ఆల్ ఓవర్ ది వరల్డ్ అండ్ ప్రొపగేటెడ్ ద మెసేజ్ ఆఫ్
సారళమ్మ, ఇందులాష, ఇలాంటి అడ్డాలకు ఎన్నిటికో తట్టుకొని నట్టుకొని వచ్చారు.
Saralamma and Indulal Shah could face all the obstacles in their way.
కానీ అతను అచంచలమైనటువంటి ఒక భక్తితో, అప్రమేయ దీంతో దాన్ని సాధిస్తూ వచ్చారు.
He could achieve because of his unwavering faith.
Today we are on the verge of celebrating the 50th golden jubilee of the Satya Sai organization all over the world. And many of you know that the foundations of the World Organization, Bhagwan chose Shri Indulal Shah to lay the foundation of the World Organization. He is 95 years old today, but I tell you, every morning I get a call from him, what shall we do for Bhagwan today? And that is the enthusiasm at 95 of the Bhishma Pitama. Sir, we beg of you and pray to you that you allow us this unique opportunity that all of us have all over the world, that we can felicitate you on this beautiful day today. Jai Sai Ram.
Main invite karta hu Indu bhai ke felicitation ke liye Shri Ratnakar ji ko, Naganand ji ko, Shri Ashok Chavan ji ko, Shivaji Rao Moge ji ko, Gopinath Munde ji ko, Mr. Jagdishan ko. मुझे नहीं लगता कि सत्य साई हिस्ट्री में ये दिन दोबारा देखने को मिलेगा हमें. और भाइयों और बहनों, ये तालियां तब तक बजनी चाहिए जब तक ये फेलिसिटेशन पूरा ना हो जाए.
Dr. K.K. Mistry, Mr. Anantharaman.
आप लोगों को सबको ये जानकर खुशी होगी कि श्री सत्य साई सेवा संगठन, जिसकी कि हम गोल्डन जुबली सेलिब्रेट करने जा रहे हैं अगले साल, उसकी स्थापना भगवान ने इंदू भाई के हाथों ही करवाई थी आज से 50 साल पहले। आज उनकी उपस्थिति हमारे बीच में भगवान का आशीर्वाद है। आप लोग स्क्रीन पर देख सकते हैं कि यहां पर फेलिसिटेशन किस तरह से किया जा रहा है।
The citation being given to Shindulal Shah, I'd just like to read it for all. Sai's chosen instrument in his avataric mission, truly blessed with tremendous foresight and vision to execute the will of the Lord even before the call of the Lord, treading the Sai path forever, propagating his message the world over, transforming himself into Sai, behold him, the reflection of Sai. Anointed by the Lord as his true devotee, faith, determination, unwavering devotion, courage and fortitude to abide by duty, an epitome of excellence and perfection, from Sri Satya Sai Bal Vikas to Educare in every facet of Medicare and Social Care, his indelible imprints are everywhere as a yeoman service in every sphere. Nurturing the seed of Dharma Kshetra, radiating the light of Chaitanya Jyoti, uniting under the divine canopy, all for the cause of Vishwa Shanti, we the devotees of the world offer this greetings to Indulal Shah. We now continue with the program, and I'd like that Anup ji announces the next program.
Sumit, main request karta hu ki aap sare hamare guest artists ko lekar stage par aaye.
While the artists assemble, we have the privilege of releasing two more books. I'll request Sri Ashok Chavanji to release two books written by our devotees from Malaysia. We also have with us Professor Naresh Chandra, the Pro Vice Chancellor of Mumbai University, who has also been associated with the Satya Sai University in many, many ways that he has made contribution to the society there. I'll also request Brother Ramesh Savant to... Suresh is a leading surgeon from Malaysia who's written this book. And Brother Jagadishan is our Dato, Brother Jagadishan from Malaysia, who's with us here today.
Jab teri inayat par nazar jati hai, mere saai, meri aankhein bhar aati hain. तू दे रहा है हमें इस कदर कि हाथ उठने के पहले ही झोली भर जाती है। लीजिए, प्रस्तुत है पद्मश्री श्रीमती कविता कृष्णमूर्ति।
साईराम, आई एक्चुअली ब्लेस द डे व्हेन आई इन बॉम्बे व्हेन आई वाज एबल टू सिंग फॉर बाबा बिकॉज आई डिडंट रियलाइज व्हाट अ ग्रेट इन्फ्लुएंस ही इज गोइंग टू बी इन माय लाइफ एंड आफ्टर दैट Of course, I went to Puttaparthi and sang for him for a few of his birthdays. And those days, I never had the confidence that I would be able to sing straight in front of him. There was a kind of fear in my heart. But I'd like to say that the love and the kindness that Baba gave me, I've always felt through my life that whatever little I sing, I think it's his blessing and his guidance throwing light on my path. to such an extent that I think he had even predicted that I would meet my husband through music. So for all these things, I felt he's been actually the big father in my life, and I'm very, very grateful to this organization for having remembered me today, for having called me, because once again I feel he is here, and with a great deal of devotion I would like to sing these songs. And after a long time, my Guru Bhai Bhavdeep Jaipurwale is here with me. I had the great fortune of learning from his father, and it's just like a miracle that one of my friends, brother Ravi Salyankar, called me to do this album, Sai Darshan for Baba, and the songs were composed, arranged by Bhavdeep, and I always will treasure these songs. Thank you, Bhavdeep.
भक्ति भक्त भगवंत गुरु चतुष नाम बपुएक तिनके पद वंदन किए मेटत विघ्न गुरु सेवा सा
Kavitaji, thank you very much. And I remember when you mentioned Mrs. Salyankar, but I hope you know that Mrs. Salyankar Senior was one of our first Bal Vikas in charges in the city of Mumbai and one of the first Bal Vikas gurus in the city of Mumbai. And I'm sure if Veena is sitting somewhere in the audience, she'll be appreciating that we remember her and her family very, very much. I'm sure Veena and Mrs. Salyankar sitting somewhere, we respect you. Auntie is the first Bal Vikas gurus of Mumbai, and many, many gurus have learned from your hands.